of three games is ADD. Played three games of Sejuani. Yeah. Pretty close to you, actually. Speaking of where people live, Leeson's lived in the top side.
Yeah, he's gonna flash, just gets that kick. The Q easily lined up.
It's on the Jinx.
Yeah, just massive, especially if Ixu can get to a point where he can clear a minion wave. A Snowflower is going to get flayed back. In goes Songyun, as in comes Songwon as well. Snowflower, oh, there's the flash forward. Key's gonna grab it. And the ambush is there. Teddy wants to turn around, try and get a kill. He's not gonna be able to, and that's gonna be both bottom laners. Definitely a thing in Australia, as there's the Glacial Prison. Ixu's looking to lock down Lindarong. The heroic entry is there as Kuzan's going to try and join. And he manages to get the taunt. That's going to be that.
Values and base damage. Just hold on to that point for a moment.
Yeah, he wants to find this kick. Oh, there it is. In comes Ixu. The Arctic Assault is named so correctly. Permafrost there. That looked so beautiful.
This season in the promotion tournament. Poetry in motion from him, but you pop a ghost and maybe the Ragnarok can have the same impact.
Well, we'll see. Nice double play there out of key. As Ingo Sungin with the ultimate, they pick up the first one. Snowflower will be a difficult kill to get.
With the Galio and super tanky lineup, still did fine. Speaking of still doing things, we got the Leeson up top again.
Yeah, avoids the Glacial Prison this time, but the permafrost is just too much.
We're just bullying at this point.
Yeah, it feels too easy. On the side of Jinx. Oh, Umtu wants to try and get back in here to steal this one away if he can. We may actually have a team fight breaking out at just 12 minutes into this game. The ambush needs to be there by Songyun if he wants to start this one up. He does have the spray and praise. Massive damage coming down. Shockwave does absolutely nothing though. And Ixu's able to pick up a kill already. Songyun got at least one, but Lindarong, he's going to get finished off. Jinx are going to win. It's a 2-1. No one's going to be able to do Helm.
It's become a pretty common item, surprisingly, though. I guess Lindarong has to die again.
Yeah, we barely even need to commentate this. I feel like it's almost rude to draw attention.
I did say, I guess, checks. They have the Sejuani ultimate, the Braum ultimate, so many different ults, so perfect time to go for a Baron. And Songwon, he's going to be hightailing it back.
Yeah, he was back in base. The teleport is coming in from Lindarong. He wants to try and get something done here. They can soften them up a little bit, but look at how tanky these players are from Jin Air.
Songwon's still too far away.
Oh, Mickey wants to try and get a Shockwave in there. It is available once again, but Umti locks down the Baron. Songwon, like you mentioned, just not there.
Decent damage is out of turret. Just about take it. Certainly not a worthwhile trade.
Oh, well, Glacial Prison is going to completely miss as Kuzan makes his way in. There's the taunt onto two members. Shockwave into the backline. Teddy takes a lot of damage, but it's not enough. Heroic entrance right on top of himself just to make things worse, says Kuzan. That is going to be the double kill coming out for Teddy. Four dead on the side of the Rocks Tigers. And Jin Air Green, I think, in ambush as well. Just unfortunate placement there. This hook is going to land onto Ixu, and he may actually die. Does fall down very, very quickly. Songwon close to dead, but doesn't fall. And now we've got a 5v4 situation. Jin Air have to back away.
Sure.
Winds of War are there to stop Songwon from getting in amongst any more of this fight as Jin Air now wanting to turn this one around. There's a massive flash ult from Snowflower. Is Lindarong in a good spot? Hook comes in. The Sejuani. No, it's the Galio. Just gets destroyed. One up and no one on the Tigers is going to be able to help out.
Yeah, there's nothing they can do. All they can do is push out their waves. They haven't been this far at their base in, what, 10 minutes?
Yep.
They've been bunkered up since very early in the game, so no mistakes there. Hold a dragon and just right-click this game.
Yes, well, feel like that could certainly be a thing, as Lindarong is too busy dealing with Super Creep still towards the bottom lane. Feel like that has been his job for this entirety of the series. And thankfully, when you're this tanky, I mean, you don't take any damage from the Elder Dragon.
A lot is going away presence,
and I sort of hated it so much at that point. The joke wasn't funny, and then I forgot to pack them.
Well, they want to end this game, Jin Air. They've toiled for a few minutes, but this should be it.
Yeah, Super Minions pushing forward. First Nexus Turret is going to fall down. This has to be the fight from Rocks. They have to try and get something from this one. Songyun in a decent position wants to try and get that ambush kill down, but it's just not really finding it. That's a fantastic ultimate. Does get the QSS and the flash out of Songyun. Ixu's going down low, but look at this. The Caitlyn free hitting onto the Nexus if he wants to on the side of Teddy. They've traded one for one so far, but Teddy just needs to shoot this dang Nexus if he wants to win this game. It's a double kill from Sungyoon, but look at that. Finally, they turn around. And it is going to be the win for Jin Air Green Wings.
The air of inevitability about the win was sealed on the fifth death for the Jace. Ended up being 7, I believe. Finally 8 as the last fight completed. When Jace is that far behind, you know, it felt like 2,000 gold didn't tell the full story at 30 minutes because Jace from behind historically has done not much. Jace from even a little bit ahead does start to lose a bit of oomph in the late game, but this Jace, sadly, was toiling at killing super minions. Let you know that Jace was never going to be an impact. They tried to set up something, but Ixu had been on the other side of the matchup. The Sejuani, that seems to be a Jin Air or MVP-only pick, comes up strong in this particular game. And, well, one team built around Twitch, one team built around Sungyoon, the other team was four tanks, and good old reliable Teddy.